Good afternoon. Good afternoon. We will start our commencement ceremony at 12:05. We have several families that are still entering the venue. We want to make sure they have enough time to see our graduates process, so we will start at 12:05. Thank you for your patience. Good morning, and welcome to our annual commencement ceremony. Before I continue, I would be remiss if I did not stop and observe 1 minute of silence for all of the lives that we have lost and have been impacted by the dual pandemics of both racism and COVID-19. Thank you. Before we begin, I would like to introduce our guests on the stage, including our school board members. Board Chair Jim Bouchard, Vice Chair Shannon Andreessen, Board Treasurer Steve Adams, Director Rachel Hartland, who will be also helping us with signing this afternoon, Director Tanya Khan, Director Jason Ross, Clerk Katie Peterson, Associate Principal Lorenzo Farley, and Superintendent Mary Perry Reed. Our school board supports us in many ways, including our commencement ceremony each year. Thank you for your unwavering support, esteemed school board members. Let's give a round of applause for our school board and esteemed guests. Commencement ceremonies mark the celebration of a completion of graduation requirements. I am honored to welcome our Hopkins families, friends, neighbors, staff, and those attending virtually from all across the world. Last and certainly not least, welcome to the class of 2022. You look amazing. I am especially impressed with your personalized adorned caps and unique academic regalia signifying your academic excellence. We are all here to celebrate you. Please enjoy this special day. Before we move forward in our program, I would like to introduce Jeffrey, Saeed, and Laura, who will read my welcome address in Hmong, Somali, and Spanish. Please give them a round of applause.
Hello. I'm gonna start off real quick. Malin Waxana Kasa Dawada Furi Tonka Hafladin Sanaka Kalinja Binta Inta Anna Akudo Kidulin Wahan Rabna Inosumeno Hadukhu O Amusna Aona Kano Hussein Daman Dadki Udintahe Hananku COVID-19 Kudumeo John Bichard Kudumeo Kuhigan Shannon Anderson Maladia Steve Adams Director Rachel Hartland Director Tanya Khan Director Jason Roche Clerk Katie Peterson and Superintendent Dr. Roder Mary Perry Reed Wahanu Lenehi, Adbat Ogu, Mahad Santihin, Enagosabi Neno, Adban Ogu Fahar, Sunnihi, Inakusudueno, Deman As Habita, Dera Shakalaha, Koisaka, Digma Hopkins, Hambalio Hambalio, Class of 2022. This was the best I could do. Thank you so much. And Class of 2022, I just want to say we did it. Can we all give each other a round of applause?
I'm a little short, so don't be short.
Jen Bouchard, to Luchu, Shannon Anderson, to Tashai Shua Nyatia, Steve Adams, to Tokyo, Rachel Hartland, or Yaitu or Gombedo, Dai Yashan, Huna, to Tokyo, Tanya Khan, to Tokyo, Jason Ross, to Tokyo, Katie Peterson, Tia, to Tokyo, the Ya Chicken, the Ya Hopkins, na Ya Mary Perry Reed. We Yomola Shada, Moshe Wahalu, Tian Tia, Tatahoke, Babe Yotun Tai, Tiliga, the Tia, Yato, Solution. Ojorone Toke, Tanga Nuna Ya Inu, Chi Saint, Tobe Yotun Tai, or Token, the Tia, Ike. 古中学在到做节能，做做朋友，那到叫人介绍，接下叫请大家我好了，那要到这宝贝，头个呢古中学在到叫东菜罗，我到跟到爹，要到阿爸那个阿奶，奶奶一路。 错度，无论节目论起，要做几种事。其他的是，你错度，中国有太上朝，凭你老个嘛，太给，看着我跟到爹。侬那别晓得多，那那要多我几种事，做你做给跟到爹上呢。你只要么做几种事，做你都肯，侬那么我赚到。
Bienvenidos, buenos días y bienvenidos a nuestra ceremonia anual de graduación. Antes de continuar, sería negligente si no nos detuviéramos y guardáramos un minuto de silencio por todas las vidas que se han perdido y que han sido afectadas por la doble pandemia del racismo y del COVID-19. Antes de comenzar, me gustaría presentar a nuestros invitados en el escenario, incluidos los miembros de nuestro consejo escolar. La presidenta de la Junta, Jen Bouchard, la vicepresidente, Shannon Anderson, el tesorero del consejo, Steve Adams, la directora, Rachel Hartland, que también ayudará a firmar esta noche. La directora, Tanya Khan, el director, Jason Ross, la secretaria, Katie Peterson, y el superintendente, Mary Perry Reed. Nuestro consejo escolar nos apoya de muchas maneras, incluyendo nuestra ceremonia de graduación cada año. Gracias por su apoyo inquebrantable, estimados miembros de la Junta Escolar. Demos un aplauso a nuestra Junta Escolar de Hopkins. Las ceremonias de graduación marcan la celebración de la finalización de los requisitos de graduación. Me siento honrada de dar la bienvenida a nuestras familias de Hopkins, amigos, vecinos, maestros y los que asisten virtualmente desde muchas partes del mundo. Por último, y ciertamente no menos importante, den la bienvenida a la clase del 2022 a su ceremonia de graduación. Están impresionantes. Estoy especialmente impresionada con sus gorras adornadas de forma personalizada y sus insignias académicas que significan su excelencia académica. Estamos todos aquí para celebrarlos. Disfruten de este día tan especial para ustedes.
Good afternoon, everyone. Before we begin, we'd like to ask all senior musicians to please move to their ensemble groups.
Hello, and welcome to the commencement ceremony for the Hopkins High School class of 2022. My name is Emma Cohen-Pesch.
And my name is Imani Karamungi, and we are your masters of ceremonies today.
We're going to take a moment to recognize the flags that we have behind us, which are also listed in your program. These flags represent the different nationalities and backgrounds with which our graduates identify.
Now that we're sitting here reminiscing over our high school years, we should emphasize how crazy the last two have been.
Yep, they've been something else, Imani. We've known each other since seventh grade when we met on the North Junior High swim team, and since then, the last few high school swim seasons have really taught us a lot.
Personally, going to swim practice was one of the rare occasions I left my house in the fall of 2020. During this time, I learned that being a swimmer helped us keep our heads above the water during COVID, literally. We hope everyone else found some kind of structure, community, or new normal that helped them swim through the last 2 years like we did.
Having three different head coaches in just 2 years really brought our team together, teaching us how to be both resilient and flexible with our constantly changing environment. As athletes, we really came together to support each other emotionally and learned how to get each other through tough times.
Yeah, that was a crazy time. Swimming is a skill we need all our lives, and the way we adapted through the pandemic helped us develop new strengths that we will forever have in the 21st century workforce and social environment.
I also know that countless other classmates have had parallel experiences through their sports, clubs, activities, and groups. Our robotics team is a prime example of a Hopkins group that thrived under these circumstances. Earlier this spring, they qualified for and competed at the World Championships Robotics Competition in Houston, Texas.
When we each follow our own paths, whether we're staying close to home, traveling across the country, or moving to a whole different continent, we can put the skills we've gained over the last few years to good use.
Agreed. Let's give it up for the class of 2022. And now, I am honored to introduce our first student speaker. Angel Riley is a hardworking... Angel Riley is a hardworking, passionate, and talented student, community member, and singer. In her time at Hopkins High School, she has been involved in theater, choir, social justice work, and has also served as a student representative on the school board. She has been involved in organizing peaceful protests and documenting the impact of George Floyd on the city of Minneapolis. She also advocated for representation of BIPOC student voices and increased hiring of BIPOC teachers and staff when she was invited to be on a panel at the Leadership Twin Cities Education Day. I've had the pleasure of singing alongside Angel in both Midori and in this spring's musical Little Women. I have seen both her great amount of talent and her great dedication with my own eyes. She is such a hard worker and it pays off. I'm so excited for her as she heads off to study journalism and theater and drama next year at the University of Wisconsin, River Falls. Please welcome Angel Riley.
Hey, y'all. thank you, Emma, so much for that wonderful introduction. The class of 22 has finally made it to the big day. In fact, one of the few days we'll remember for the rest of our lives. We've been through hell and more hell. I look back on the past 2 years, and all I can think is, how did we do it? The duration of our life as high schoolers was surrounded by death, sickness, and injustice. We spent our lives as high schoolers teaching today's society what real leadership looks like through our constant activism through things like women's rights and racial injustice. We showed what it is to be constructive and professional, unlike a certain parent Facebook group, who showed what integrity does not look like, to show us all to be mindful of what we say and what we think, and to always be open-minded to all circumstances. We as a class are bold, and we are not to be taken lightly. When we speak about our beliefs and dreams, we force those around us to listen, and if they choose to ignore it, we do what we came to do anyway, because one way or another, we will get somebody's attention. The legacy we leave behind will be a great one. I know because we as a student body have done more for ourselves at Hopkins than anybody else can take credit for. The class of 2022 has unfortunately been through literal history. The things that we lived through will be talked about long before we find our purpose in this world. And as bad as it was, it taught us some valuable life lessons. Lesson number one, always keep an extra mask in your car, obviously. But no, on a serious note, always be ready. I don't mean the kind of ready where you are completely prepared and aware of what's about to happen. No, I mean the type of ready where in whatever situation or circumstance, you will not hesitate to take action, to take the matter into your own hands and lead by example. Number two, fail. Yeah, do the exact thing you fought tooth and nail not to do. Anything that isn't constantly challenged grows weak. Got that one from a video game. Take me, for example. I had my entire life planned out. I knew what I wanted to do, where I wanted to go, and how I was going to get there. I was going to pass high school with flying colors. Well, I passed, but without the flying colors part. I didn't do bad. In my sophomore year, I was actually on it. Like, I felt like Rihanna after she finally dropped her album. Like, who wouldn't want that? But then junior year hit. Things changed for the worse, and I felt empty, lost. My mental health was trash, my oldest niece had passed, and my grades reflected it all. Finally, my senior year, I got waitlisted to my dream college. I felt like all my pain and suffering was in vain. I was like, well, what did I not do? Was I not smart enough? Did I not have the classes they were looking for? Or was my personal essay boring? I will never know the answers to these questions, but what I do know is that I was never meant to go there. The point is, it will stop you from making mistakes that you probably won't be able to come back from. I was going to put myself in a position that more than likely would have left me in a lot of debt. This helped me realize that everything we want in the world is not always what we need. So when you fail, cry about it, but then move on and cry about it some more, because let's be honest, it's never that quick and easy. But when you finally do accept things for what they are, you'll understand and you'll realize things would not have turned out the way you wanted them in that moment. And lesson number three, always prioritize you. If that means removing someone from your life, then do it. If that means quitting a job, then do it. If that means taking a leap of faith and moving to a completely different state, then do it. As the famous actress Gabrielle Union said, when you prioritize yourself, you save yourself. Lastly, I want to shout out the friends who I've lost, the friends who I've rekindled with, and the friends I will forever have a bond with. You gave me some amazing life lessons, and I will forever be grateful to you. Y'all made school for me because I know I hated it, but always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one. So many futures in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. And it's so hard to say goodbye. Yesterday's gone, we gotta keep moving on. I'm so grateful for the moments. So glad I got to know you. The times that we had, I'll keep like a photograph and hold you in my heart forever. I'll always remember you. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Thank you, Angel. Declaration Overture by Claude T. Smith is written in celebration of momentous occasions. Our combined instrumental performance features many of our 22 orchestra and 38 band graduating seniors who have made a commitment through a pandemic and virtual lessons to continue playing music throughout high school. We recognize their perseverance and commitment to the musical community at Hopkins High School and are honored that they would spend their senior year making music at a high level. Please welcome our scholar instrumentalists performing Declaration Overture.
Thank you.
Thank you for that amazing performance. Toby Sanders, our second student speaker, exemplifies the qualities of a determined, dedicated, and driven individual. She has been thoroughly involved in a variety of programs both inside and outside of Hopkins High School, some of which include being a swim and dive captain, where I had the pleasure of witnessing her compassionate leadership firsthand, as well as being a member of the National Honor Society. Outside of Hopkins, Toby previously served on the regional board for United Synagogue Youth, worked with B'nai Mitzvah students at her synagogue, and is going to be a counselor at Herzl Camp this summer, where she has spent her past 8 summers. Toby will, without a doubt, remain deeply involved in her community when she attends the University of Denver, where she will major in international studies and minor in leadership. Please welcome Toby Sanders.
Thank you, Imani. Good afternoon, family, friends, faculty, and the Hopkins High School class of 2022. My name is Toby Sanders, and I am proud to be part of the best group of students to come out of Hopkins High School, the class of 2022. We are the only class to come out of Hopkins that has not had one single normal year of high school, and we still have managed to stick together through it all to make it to this day. We entered kindergarten in 2009, before One Direction even existed, and I vividly remember being shown an iPad for the first time that year. My class was in awe of how big the screen was. Little did we know, we would have our very own in 7 years, and most of us would use it to play 2048 during 10-minute reading time until a teacher caught us. In junior high, we expanded our worlds, both figuratively and literally. Hopkins enabled us to meet some of our very best friends because of the inclusive, community-centered, and welcoming environment that exists. As much as we hated seating charts, without them, many of us wouldn't have met the people we depend on today. Nothing is quite like the bond between the people you sit near in a hard class. At Hopkins, we were also still able to work with those that weren't necessarily our people because teachers created a space in their classrooms in which we felt safe to try new things and make mistakes. The first day of sophomore year, we were ready to embrace all that high school had to offer and live out the rest of our teenage years in glory. Sophomore year was filled with heart monitors and gym class and cafeteria ice cream, but then suddenly everything came to a halt. My Snapchat memories tell the story. COVID canceled cafeteria ice cream, frowny face emoji, and 2 weeks off of school, happy face emoji. Little did we know, those 2 weeks would give way to a month, and then to the rest of sophomore year, and then to today. Those months we spent online were painfully uneventful, mostly due to the fact that our once smiling faces entering class at the ring of a bell were now what Mr. Rexroth called Skittles, popping up with a ding on the Google Meet screen. Our junior year was much easier than it should have been, but I do not think there are any complaints. Motivation was down, and the year was full of lots of scrolling through Wikipedia. While junior year may have been a bust, we were all determined to make up for it senior year. This year, we had the unique opportunity to both revive old traditions and start new ones. With the return of Friday night football games, a spirited Royal Athletic Center for basketball games, and starting new traditions like making our homecoming dance formal, along with the help of an appearance on The Bachelorette and a visit from Gronk, I can confidently say that we did it. We made a mark on Hopkins High School. Hopkins has taught us that a little adversity is okay. Through all the changes, trials, and successes we have been through, we have still managed to find the positive in it all. We continue to come to school because of the people and the opportunities it presented to us. The mall provided us with comfort and a feeling of belonging. Hopkins taught us that even if it feels like the world is spinning off its axis, the unchanging classrooms and halls of Hopkins High gave us stability and a place we knew we were safe. Through these past 13 years, we have raised each other and grown up, but now it is time to use all that we have learned and leave this place that we have called home. This all leads us to this very moment. This is our moment as the class of 2022 to take the time and appreciate us, something we don't do enough of. Among us, we have state championship athletes, budding scientists, talented artists, future politicians, and who knows what other talents and skills we will all discover. Through all the studying, late nights, and tests taken, we finally made it to the day that we've dreamed of. Now the question is, what comes next? I know that every single one of us has the capacity to change lives for the better, because we already have, with little things like a compliment in the hallway, and with bigger things like starting new clubs and leading protests to make changes we want to see in our community. Our future will include so many successes and some failures that will make us stronger. I know the phrase, "that person went to Hopkins with me," will be something I'll be proud to say 20 years from now. Before I end, I would like to thank the people that have enabled us to reach this moment. To our families, thank you for putting up with us in quarantine and for keeping us motivated during a time when it was almost impossible to do so. Thank you for your unconditional love and support, and maybe even for the 11 o'clock curfew. And finally, to our Hopkins teachers, I would like to thank you all for your endless support and understanding. You all encouraged us to be the best versions of ourselves and never told us that there is a path we couldn't take or a person we couldn't be. If the past 3 years were challenging for us, then they were even more challenging for you all. I know that we will all be forever grateful for the connections we've made with you and the inspiration you give us every day to be better students and overall better people. I cannot thank you enough. And with that, I would like to congratulate you all on finally making it to the final scene of High School Musical. Thanks for the memories, Hopkins. You will be missed. Thank you.
Thank you, Toby. I'm honored to introduce Midori, an audition treble a cappella ensemble that meets outside the regular school day. They will be singing The Parting Glass, a traditional Irish farewell song, rather appropriate as we all head off in our separate paths towards exciting futures. As the last line, says, good night and joy be with you all. Please welcome Midori.
Hello.
Okay. Thank you. Principal Ballard has been with the Hopkins High School administration for 2 years. Throughout this time, despite the pandemic circumstances, she has consistently followed the Vision 2031 path by doing things like centering student voice, including in the hiring process, and moving toward more restorative justice practices. She has also worked hard to increase the number of staff members of color at the high school to better reflect our diverse student population. Despite all of the ups and downs, Principal Ballard has made it a point to express her concern for her students through her words and actions. Along with that, she has also partnered with staff as we emerge from COVID in order to better support students and reset expectations at the high school. Principal Ballard has made dozens of connections with students from every grade level, even going so far as to say hello and check in with you while walking down the halls. Please welcome our esteemed principal, Ms. Crystal Ballard.
Thank you, Imani. Class of 2022. During your first year of high school, the world changed. We were at the height of COVID-19, and schools across the country were required to pivot to distance learning formats. This was a frightening time for me as an adult, and I cannot imagine how this felt for you as sophomores entering their first year of high school. That year, during the month of March and the remainder of the school year, brought so much uncertainty and added new words and phrases to our daily vocabularies, like global pandemic, pivot, and asynchronous learning. This year for you was surprisingly unique because it was actually your first full year of high school. Imagine that, your first full year and last school year has happened. You showed so much grace during these challenging years. Although it felt very long, it always felt hopeful. This class, your class, is full of amazing leaders that I have personally had the privilege to work alongside. I have watched you use your voices to make positive changes in our school and also our community. You have served in several important leadership roles, including working with our school board. I have watched in awe as you post pictures on Instagram identifying your plans for next year. Whoever is running that IG account has amazing graphic design skills. You excelled through countless AP exams, rigorous courses, and remember to smile and thank others. You are brilliant. You are bold and embody so much resilience as a class. In spite of the many challenges you have faced, you have made it to this milestone event. Your teachers, your families, your neighbors, our school district, and every other support system that exists is extremely proud of you. One of the most attractive values I believe we hold as a district is love. I want you to know that we love you dearly, and it is my personal honor to continue to watch you grow and do amazing things throughout the world. Congratulations, class of 2022. This is your day. You absolutely deserve it. Job well
done. You all have been an amazing group of seniors. I am very thankful to have had an opportunity to serve as your principal. This is only the beginning of the amazing things you will do in the world. Congratulations.
Thank you, Principal Ballard. Dr. Miri Puri Reed is serving in her fifth year as superintendent for schools for Hopkins. She has previously been a social studies teacher, high school principal, and assistant district leader. Dr. Reed is passionate about public education. She believes that helping all students experience a high-quality education is our moral as well as economic duty. Dr. Reed loves Hopkins because of the staff who bleed blue and community members who continuously rally their support. Dr. Reed has a fourth and eighth grader who attend Hopkins, and she absolutely loves spending time at our high school. Please welcome Superintendent Dr. Miri Puri Reed.
Thank you so much, Emma. Good afternoon, Hopkins Royals, seniors, staff, parents, caregivers, and friends. You've heard many words of inspiration from our senior speakers and our principal. For all of us to be together, to have breath, to recognize our young people's efforts, and to imagine all of their possible and bright futures, this is a unique and special time. Some of you are here celebrating your first high school graduate. As the oldest of seven, my mother and father attended seven high school commencements, followed by seven college graduations. Each of those 14 occasions was embraced with renewed and unbridled excitement. I know that's how our parents and grandparents and all other family members are feeling about their high school graduate today. Hopkins seniors, your journey here was made far more difficult by our current context. All the speakers have talked about this. As a superintendent, I always think about context and all the ways it informs learning and thriving. Context matters. Our microenvironments and the experiences we have in them are continuously shaped by the larger and even global context that surrounds us. A single experience could be easy or difficult, forgettable or indelible, solely based on what else is happening with surrounding conditions. Clearly, COVID and all of the enormous challenges this pandemic brought with it made your journey to today's high school graduation exceptionally complex. The road here was not simple. Yours was a difficult path, yet well-traveled. As Toby shared earlier, you haven't had a typical school year in the last 3 years, and yet all 536 of you have pioneered bravely. You've faced personal and social isolation. You attended school wearing required masks, whether you wanted to or not. How will we ever know the impact that events such as the Russian war, racialized violence, school shootings, and so many other dreadful world affairs will have on your psyche and on your worldview? Context matters. For each of you, there was likely a time in the last 2 years when you had to face yourself in the mirror and will yourself to rise up, to not give up, to face your current context. All of this is why we are so proud of you and why this moment in your life is significant. Here is more of what makes us proud. 69.6% of you have earned a grade point average of 3.0 or higher. Since sophomore year, 88% of you have participated in at least one after-school activity, athletic team, or club. Because of your grades and extracurricular commitments, members of this class earned nearly $50,000 just in local scholarships. This spring, 708 HHS students took more than 800 advanced placement tests. This means many of you will earn college credit with your passing scores on these difficult exams. 48 of you earned the Minnesota Bilingual Seal. 22 of you will be committed college athletes at universities across this country. Since you started kindergarten, Hopkins has won 30 state championships, and our girls winning the state basketball title this year, the Technocrats going to the World Cup, and so much more. From advocating at Hopkins Speaks Out, Student Council, or even the state legislature, to braving musical and theatrical performances, and of course, LMPM, there are far more accomplishments than time to properly mention. You have sacrificed, you have learned, and now you have earned this recognition. Know how proud we are of each of you. And now some advice. Although centennials, that's you, make up only 25% of the US population, you are a valued generation. It is imperative for you to know your true worth and for you to wield it as carefully as you would a sharp sword. Growing up on the internet has made you socially keen and globally minded. Balance this with empathy and perspective taking. Don't lose sight of our precious shared humanity. As young people, you think deeply, but you don't value the same things as previous generations. Always balance your original thinking with respect for other people's opinions. Don't try to be right. Instead, seek to hear and understand. Centennials are also less interested in following other people's rules and more interested in setting new social and political engagements. This is natural, and the world needs change. But as you define new ways of being, work with your generation to promote self-care and love for others, new voices being heard, civil rights being protected, and peace over war. Because you have pioneered new paths in the midst of difficult contexts, you will also be engineers of new ideas and solutions. The flags in this space showcase more than the country heritages represented here today. They are also welcoming you to the world. You are valiantly ready for it. We wish you continued courage, self-love, and Godspeed toward your true purpose. Congratulations, class of 2022.
As you may have already noticed, our scholars are adorned in a very personalized regalia. I would like to draw your attention to our scholars who have excelled academically. In addition, scholars who have contributed to Hopkins High School in powerful, diverse ways. Scholars who devoted themselves to intentionally engaging in a nationally recognized college readiness program called Advancement Via
individual determination.
Avid are wearing stoles. Please wave.
Scholars who have earned a 4.0 grade point average are wearing a gold tassel and a gold stole. Please wave. Scholars who have earned a 3.75 through 3.99 grade point average are wearing a gold tassel and a gold cord. Please wave. Scholars who have earned a 3.5 through 3.749 are wearing a gold tassel. Please wave. Scholars who are wearing red and blue cords are members of our American Sign Language Honor Society. Please wave. All of our scholars who have contributed to Hopkins High School as a school and community are beyond powerful. They have showed their leadership through various clubs, activities, societies, unions, and memberships, and they have the regalia to reflect those things. Scholars, please wave. It is always important for us to acknowledge those that cannot be here. There are members of this class that did not make it to this day. For those who have lost their lives, we light this candle to remember them. Although they are not here, their memories will live on in our thoughts and our hearts. And now, the moment that you have been waiting for. We will first hear from our superintendent.
Aww. It'll be quick. Ladies and gentlemen, School Board Chair Jen Bouchard and members of the Hopkins School Board and community, each 2022 graduate honored in our presence this afternoon has successfully met Minnesota state requirements in order to proudly receive the Hopkins Public Schools diploma. We are proud to present to you the graduating class of 2022. Congratulations.
Check, check. All right. Here we go. Ikran Abdi.
Hamza Abdallah.
Sadat Abdullahi.
Saeed Abdi.
Lauren Albrecht.
Ayub Abdul Qadir.
Edna Ahmed.
Gilbert Adamako.
Solomon Ahmed.
Khalid Ahmed.
Hannah Ali.
Sabrina Ahmed.
Fartoon Ali.
Shamarke Ahmed.
Benjamin Allen.
Mumtaz Ali.
Wendy Amaro Castillo.
Roby Ali.
Aishak Amin.
Angel Allison.
Joshua Anderson.
Kitson Amdahl.
Donna Andrade Medrano.
Daniela Anampa Castro.
Cade Arms Reginald.
Alyssa Anderson.
Annika Arvidson.
Nina Andrasco.
Naimo Barr.
Shakia Arrington Bates.
Michelle Batur.
Aaron Ani.
Sarson Better.
Lucas Barker.
Elsa Bergman.
Amaya Battle.
Jaden Bernard.
Jack Bauer.
Zuri Bethel.
Colton Bain.
Crown Bison.
Kara Bergam Stegman.
Anthony Bostic.
Connor Besky.
Liam Brady.
Maxwell Binnaker.
Pamela Brachado Martinez.
Leah Bosch.
Julia Downing.
John Bottomiller.
Bryce Buckingham.
Connor Brace.
Russell Bollock.
Margot Brittain.
Thomas Burke.
Naisa Brown.
Maxwell Byrne.
Robert Buckingham.
Nicole Campagnola.
Samuel Broyles.
Tyus Porter.
Aiden Burr Anen.
Ashley Chase.
Annika Berman.
Sajan Chesson.
Ty Calloway.
Ronald Chasumbai.
Caleb Carr.
Jason Che.
Rose Casas.
Aaron Shinovar.
Veronica Chapanduka.
Stella Christensen.
Parker Chelikowski.
Mark Cleveland.
Coleman Chin.
Ezra Cofield Williams.
Sarah Collar.
Francesca Comelli Castro.
Charles Clays.
Leonel Contreras Mondragon.
Emma Cohen Pesh.
Zachary Conway.
Gabriella Cole.
Maris Coven.
Isaiah Kolstock.
Precious Craig.
Elena Contreras.
Django Crane.
Takira Conway.
Gavin Chrysler.
Benjamin Kopp.
Elijah Cruz.
Kira Cox.
Aisha DeCall.
Janessa Crandell.
Noah Day.
Rikia Crenshaw.
Juliana Daler.
Adelaide Crowell.
Ramatula Dem.
Yella Dahinden.
Bile Diblawe.
Shanita Davis.
Harper Dirks.
Devin Deering.
Ali Dijama.
Abubakar Dem.
Kyle Duvall.
Hadja Diano.
Peter Eklund.
Catherine Diedrich.
Janaea Evans Curry.
Evan Ditzler.
Sophia Farrell.
Mitchell Dolanchuk.
Nash Feinstein.
Jackson Druck.
Mariette Fulner.
William Duffy.
Calvin Firth.
Randall Dua.
Delaney Fogel.
Jesse Escaveria.
Elise Ford.
Omari Evans Thomas.
Kendasia Freeman.
Luca Finley.
Annalise Froderman.
Pablo Flutstrom.
Lindsay Gosh.
Eric Forbert.
Jair Garces Vargas.
Aisha Fraser.
Isaac Goderman.
Ruth Freiberg.
John Gozich.
Leo Formel.
Drew Geyser.
Zachary Gale.
Maria Gerard.
Justin Garcia Sanchez.
Dustin Gohl.
Samuel Gosman.
Jonathan Gomez Monteros.
Madeline Boyer.
Sophie Grandland.
Selma Gelly.
Emma Gray.
Riley Glander.
Carson Green.
Samuel Goldman.
Jack Grodnick.
Aislinn Gorder.
Deja Gustafson.
Lauren Granger.
Rosalie Hall.
Finnegan Greeley.
Peter Handley.
Thomas Griffiths.
Simone Harris.
Josue Guacho.
Jock Harris.
Sydney Hall.
Nicholas Hartley.
Harrison Hansen.
Adna Hassan.
McKenna Harris.
Mandela Halsey.
Hallie Hartley.
Estella Heath.
Levin Hassan.
Georgia Helfter.
Megan Howard.
Libby Herman.
Sophia Hayes.
Blaine Herndon.
Paul Heeb.
Laura Hilguera Vivas.
David Hernandez.
Jamarion Hill.
Kitana Highsmith.
Gabriel Hirschman.
Zaria Hill.
Sydney Hoffman.
James Hill.
Greg Hopkins.
Jua Hickson.
Easton Hoyle Thompson.
Jenna Holden.
Micah Hunter.
Nakoma Howard.
Bergen Husef.
Sydney Hughes.
Amber Hischelin.
Isabella Hertz.
Isabel Inga Dutan.
Lee Hutton.
Kendall Isaacson.
Mubarak Ibrahim.
Ayan Jama.
Justin Irsang.
Kamal Jama.
Abdirahman Jama.
Catherine Jance.
Bahja Jama.
Max Johnning.
Chris Christopher Jimenez Lopez.
Caden Johnson.
Brandon Johnson.
Jasmine Johnson.
Jayana Johnson.
Lindsay Johnson.
Lars Johnson.
Sion Jordan.
Connor Dunker.
Justin Cadet.
Eli Collar.
Gabriel Kahn.
Taylor Katzenmeyer.
Leela Moon Carlson.
Nick Kelly.
Cole Kerber.
Imani Karimongi.
Bug Kemper.
Jonah Kilker.
Noah Kadani Merriam.
Colton Knutson.
Anna Cadet.
Julius Coley.
Miles Koppelman.
Yetta Koritz.
Raleigh Koritz.
Olivia Kratz.
Caden Cryenbrink.
Seth Crystal.
Andre Crystal.
Jessica Curis.
Thomas Kylo.
Jordan Cairola.
Amber Cryola. Cairola.
Michaela Lambert.
Troy Landskook.
Isabel Larson.
Sydney Lay.
Lissa Lee.
Victor Lascano.
Mackens Falui.
Gao Lee Lee.
Maya Lee.
Rain Lee Kohlhoff.
Joseph Lepley.
Samuel Levitt.
Heather Llewellyn.
Edgar Kinanga.
Madeline Lilly.
Safaria Lewis.
Miles Luce.
Delaney Lindstrom.
Anna Lawrencer.
Angelo Lockhart.
Basil Lulu.
Nicholas Lopez.
Annabelle Lyons.
Peyton Lovell.
Gabriella Maldonado.
Guy Lumley.
Amir Mansour.
Alan McKay.
Ray Martins Goldman.
Jackson Malone.
Alana Martinez.
Leo Marquez Sanchez.
Jasmine Mata.
Jeannie Martin.
Finn McBride.
Gavin Maston.
Fergus McConnell.
Sophia Matthew.
Claire McKim.
Jack Mauser.
Lakaya McNair.
Liam McAllister.
Alexa Mendez Cordova.
Samuel McCarthy.
Kosen Mestemacher.
Katrina McKim.
Colin Middlecoff.
Jameer McKinney.
Sonia Milkovich.
Jessica Meeks.
Bridget Miller.
Maxwell Menke.
Samantha Min.
Ellie Mytheller.
Abdirahman Mohammed.
Maddox Mikalakis.
Mustafa Mohammed.
Sarah Miller.
Nabat Mohammed.
Alexander Manau.
Isan Mohamud.
Helena Mitchell.
Marissa Maldo.
Amin Mohammed.
Dylan Moore.
Nabila Mohammed.
Adasha Moser.
Mohammed Mahmoud.
Lauren Munger.
Grace Munson.
Isis Knowles.
Emma Morley.
Bennett Nelson.
Salma Molid.
Joshua Nenadich.
Aisha Muse.
Kong Nguyen.
Walter Nagasi.
Elvis Naji.
Evan Nelson.
Elizabeth Norman.
Kate Nielsen.
Yvonne Tegeye.
Maya Naji.
Sonia Nyakundi.
Matthew Norton.
Olivia Olson.
Yvette Tegeye.
David Omai.
Casey Odell.
Willie Omar.
Christian Odom.
Sam Orvidal.
Gabriel Olson.
Oliver Osland.
Trevor Olson.
Noah Otmar.
Guled Omar.
Greta Palmeter.
Yahi Omar.
Eve Passman.
Sam Orvidal.
Vivian Paulson.
Ridwan Osman.
Kylie Peterson.
Nora Pavola.
Vivian Ahil Philip Longo.
Noah Paulman.
Makai Pleasant.
Jonna Parks.
Shania Porter.
Demaya Patton.
Nathaniel Presnell.
Sophia Pavelka.
Emily Pritchett.
Araya Pettiford.
Zeta Sayas.
Kaylin Pierre Toussaint.
Jacqueline Quevedo Lima.
Kendra Powell.
Maya Ramirez.
Dina Prahovsky.
Janessa Reglos.
Benjamin Pullen.
Jaden Reifsteck.
Peyton Radke.
Casper Renkert.
Macy Redmond.
Catherine Rich.
Blake Rabine.
Henry Priest.
Clyde Reddish.
Angel Riley.
David Rice.
Alani Richard.
Nolan Ryder.
Olivia Rivera.
Cecilia Rittenauer.
Quinn Roberts.
Alexander Rivas.
Alex Robles.
Dylan Roberts.
Lucia Rock.
Nisha Robinson.
Heidi Romero Ruiz.
Monica Robles.
Felipe Saavedra.
Marvin Rodriguez.
Paul Safransky.
Zachary Rosenberg.
Asia Saeed.
Osvaldo Saavedra Cruz.
Isabella Saladino.
Siri Sagadal.
Omar Samantar.
Nimco Saeed.
Toby Sanders.
Giovanni Salvatore.
Benjamin Sarapa.
Eldil Samatar.
Ollie Shackman.
Tyrell Sappington.
Sophie Shear.
Calvin Saunders.
Deanna Schmaltz.
Charles Schaefer.
Isaiah Schmitz.
Henry Scheibel.
Logan Schuchard.
Gabriel Schmidt.
Mila Seafelt.
Sophie Schmitz.
Ellie Siegel.
Grant Schweigert. Laney Service.
Bayard Shaver.
Ananya Sharma.
Storm Simon.
Zachary Sickink.
Lillian Sojos Ortiz.
Lena Skovronik.
Manuel Sotelo.
Samuel Sorensen.
Claire Stanek.
Kimberly Stemper.
Isabella Stewart.
Megan Stoldorf.
Charles Strozinski.
John Strike.
Benjamin Sullivan.
Gracie Sundell.
Eleanor Sweeney.
Aiden Swartz.
Roshan Tajbaj.
Edward Taylor Collins.
Ariadne Terrazes Gonzalez.
I'll say it as you go up. Moti Terese.
Jimeng Tao.
Milka Tessima.
Catherine Thiel.
Sunny Tao.
Ryan Thierry Ajiegwu.
Jack Thier.
Javaris Thompson.
Christopher Thompson.
Mackenzie Tucker.
Linnea Tix.
Miriam Traor.
Abigail Toll.
Noel Trung.
Tori Trevina.
Aaron Vasquez.
Catherine Van Alstein.
Fernando Villanueva Jimenez.
Anthony Vasquez.
Chimeng Vu.
Ramiro Veren Echuari.
Emma Waihu.
Charles Wagner.
Patrice Walton.
Aiden Wallingford.
Dorothea Watson.
Shayla Wandry.
Kevin Weber.
Camden Watts.
Riley Weidenfeller.
Lanaya Weddington.
Jamie Weiss.
Henry Weinman.
Simon White.
Josephine White.
Benjamin Wigley.
Eleanor Witte.
Jackson Williams.
Zoe Wilkerson.
Silas Wilson.
Timone Williams.
Marley Wisdom.
Edward Winkler.
Ryan Witte.
Rich Wise.
Lucas Wright.
Hannah Williter.
Jua Zhang.
Liu Zhang.
Susan Zhang.
Kairos Yang.
Aceline Yang.
Caitlin Young.
Fatima Yusuf.
Abdi Yusuf.
Fatima Yusuf.
Brock Zimmer.
Will the class of 2022 please stand? Move your tassels from the right to the left. Congratulations. This concludes our commencement exercise.